Hi, everybody. This is Nick, and we're going to talk about saving time in your reporting process when you make reports in PowerPoint instead of other report writing apps like Word. So one of the things we have written about a lot and made videos about a lot here on this channel is using PowerPoint to make these reports. And you can see right here, I have a pretty standard report size page. It's like that portrait orientation, that 8.5 by 11 size page. And I was just going to go ahead in here and start making kind of a template for my first page or for my one pager that I'm going to create in my PowerPoint file. So we have just this rectangle right here that I have for the header bar. I have a title, I have some text, and then I put in a picture here. Now, if I go to create a new report, every single time I'm going to have to open a new PowerPoint file. It already defaults to that slide size, that 16 by 9 orientation, so I'm going to have to change the dimensions every time. So here's how you change the dimensions of your slide. When you open PowerPoint, you go up to the Design tab and then over to the Slide Size menu right here, and then click on Custom Slide Size. Now you can see that in my slide deck right here, we've already set our custom dimensions. So you're going to go ahead and from the drop-down menu, just select custom, or you could select the letter paper size 8.5 by 11. But when you select 8.5 by 11, it actually defaults to 7.5 by 10 automatically in PowerPoint. So you have to still go in here and hard code that if you want those dimensions to be right, and then just maximize the slide space. Another thing I make sure to do is click on the portrait orientation. If we click on landscape orientation, that's going to make an 8.5 by 11 page, but it's going to be a wider orientation. So make sure that portrait is selected, and then click OK when you're finished creating your slide dimensions. Now, this would be a really great start for my sort of report in PowerPoint for my page. But if I wanted to go ahead and not have to do any of those introductory steps anytime I wanted to make a report, I'm going to go ahead and save this as a template file. So right now we are presentation 5. You can see the title up here in the left hand corner, presentation 5 PowerPoint. If I go to the file tab and go to the save tab, or the save as tab, let's look at that. You can see that we default to PowerPoint presentation file, that's .pptx. Now, if I want to save this as a template file, all I have to do is click on that drop-down menu and click on the PowerPoint template right here, .potx. So if I click on that, you'll see that changes. And let's go ahead and just save this to my desktop so we can see it. I'm going to say report template. I already saved one of them, so I'm going to do report template 2. And we're going to go ahead and save that. And now when I close out of this, let's go ahead and see which one we can find here, if that was a different one that I had created. And let's see, here we go. I'm gonna look over here on this side. Here's my number 2 right here. Look at this beautiful palm cockatoo. Don't you love that? Love that bird. Okay, so here's my report. You can see right here in the file name, it's .potx, so that's the template file. Now, when I double-click this, it's actually going to open a new file based on the template, which is super cool. So the actual template file stays intact, and a new file pops up. So if I double-click to open, you'll now see in the upper left-hand corner, I have this presentation 6. The report template v2 is no longer there. This is a brand new file, but all of the properties from my template still stay. I have the page number, I have the text, the photo, the header bar, and the title right here, and most important, the slide orientation. So I don't have to go back and forth, go back to square one every single time and create a new report from this. So you can do this for a report like this with different dimensions, but you can also do this for your own slide presentation, for a slide deck, or for a slide doc if you have other documents that you are creating in PowerPoint and you want to do this. You can also do this in Microsoft Word. So you can template a file in Microsoft Word and save it as a template file. And then you can open that template file and it will open a new document and save the properties of that template file for later. Now, one question that I got before was how do we actually make changes to the template? Because if I double click this to open, it's always going to open a new file based on that. It's not going to open the file. So if you want to do that, all you need to do is right click and then open. Click on open. So it's just a right click and open. And when you open this document, it's going to open the POTX, the template. So you can see right here the report template.POTX. And that's then you could go ahead and make changes to your template and then close it, save it, and then your template is going to have those updates in it. So I hope this was a little trick or a little hack for you on the back end if you find yourself making new reports from scratch every single time, but they always kind of take the same look and feel, or they have the same first page or something like that. It's a really handy trick that I use a lot in my work, and it will save you precious minutes in your day. So I hope you like this video. If you do, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. I had a great time making this for you, and I can't wait to see you next time.